Hey guys, hope you're all fine and welcome to my tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm gonna talk about the power of texture channel packing. A texture channel packing consists of multiple grayscale textures which are used in red, blue, green channel of a texture map. It is used to reduce the number of textures used for physical base materials. This is a good way to make use of unused channels and keep the numbers of textures being sampled in one texture minimum. Not only it reduces the texture space, but also it will lower the usage of memory. As for the physical base materials, you will need to create not only diffuse and normals, but also metallic, roughness, specular with displacement and alpha map. Diffuse and normal will need a separate RGB texture image, but for roughness, specular, metallic, alpha or displacement, you will need these texture as they are in grayscale. These textures can be replaced in red, blue, green and alpha of a texture image. For the demonstration, I have already baked the textures for the house and for the car. You can use Photoshop or game to copy paste the textures inside of the channel. Here is how you can do it in Photoshop. First, open all the baked images of an asset inside Photoshop and then create a new 2K image. Now just select the Ambient Occlusion Texture tab and press Ctrl A to select all, or you can use the selection tool to select all and press Ctrl C to copy, and then select the new 2K image tab and inside the channel select red and then press Ctrl V to paste Ambient Occlusion inside the red channel. Then you will need to repeat it for the other texture of an asset. When you are done, save it. After that, in Blender, duplicate the asset to have a copy of it and move it aside. Then remove all the material from it and add new material to it and open diffuse normal and channel texture image that you have created for the material. To use channel textures, you will need to use separate RGB node. Then you can easily use red, blue, green channel slots and plug directly into the roughness and metallic. I have used green channel for roughness slot and blue channel for metallic slot. After that, I have used mix RGB node set to multiply, then have plugged albedo and ambient occlusion for mixing, then have set the factor to 1 and then plugged it into the base color. After that, I have used the normal map after normal texture and plugged it into the normal. Then I have used color ramp after separate RGB to have more control over the roughness and metallic. And that's pretty much about it. Hope you guys like it. If you like my tutorial, then subscribe and support me on Patreon, where you will be able to get the project files that I have used in my tutorials. Thanks for watching.